Welcome back to Drago Cinematics. I'm Lance Dragos, and today we're going to be reviewing the importance of getting your Part 107 license for flying your drone commercially, and I'm going to be illustrating all the steps you can take in order to get that license yourself. So stay tuned for the rest of the video. I'm outside of the park now. Figured there's no better way to explain to you whether or not you need your Part 107 than by actually going out and flying your drone. You have to start off by asking yourself the question whether or not you want to actually fly your drone for income. Now, this differentiates between two categories, a recreational flyer or a commercial flyer, which flies under that Part 107, FAA recognized, FAA registered, and you adhere to all the safety rules that the FAA does provide. Where do you start once you figure out whether or not you are a recreational flyer or a commercial flyer? You need to create yourself an FTN or an FAA tracking number. What this does is it essentially creates you a user profile under the FAA that you can use in order to take your drone exam and register your drone with. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna link all of the website in the description below so you have no problems getting to all the different links that I have. So now you created your FTN and you're all ready to take that exam. Something that I learned in my first time taking the exam is that it's a lot more difficult than you think it's gonna be. I failed my first exam because I didn't go into it prepared and I thought it was gonna be, you know, almost a cakewalk, like, you know, how to fly your drone, this and that. It was definitely the exact opposite of that. They really go into depth about, you know, different frequencies, and you have to learn how to read sectional charts and the US airport supplements. It's a really loaded topic, which I didn't understand first going into it. I went back to the drawing board and I was like, well, what can I do this time to better prepare myself for the exam? So of course what I did, like anybody else that was born in the 21st century or lives in the 21st century, I went online and I did a lot of research for drone schools, you know, online courses that you can take to prepare yourself to actually take that drone exam. I found courses for $400 online, and to me it just didn't seem like it was worth it. So I dove a little bit deeper and I found out about a company called FlightReady. Now this FlightReady company does a lot of different services. So they do drone services, and in addition to that, they do IFR certifications and everything like that, just different courses to help you prepare for anything aeronautical, so to speak. So if you use the code DRAGOS21 at checkout at flightready.com, you get 25% off your order. I think it brings the total down to like 75 bucks when in comparison to the $400 that you'd pay anywhere else. It is an absolutely incredible deal, seriously. It helped me pass on my second try, and I just had to reach out to them and, you know, say thank you for preparing such really an awesome course, fully loaded with everything I needed. And seriously, I can't stress enough how important it is to take a drone course. The online exams, like those free practice tests, are really great. However, there's nothing like learning about the stuff that you're testing for, knowing the topics before you go into the exam and having a different confidence going in blindly. It's a little bit more scary than going in with a full book of knowledge in your head about everything. So I'm gonna leave that in the description. It's Dragos21 at checkout. And I really, really wanna stress that it is important to take a course rather than just jumping into this blindly. Something to note is that you can't take your drone exam online. So you have to actually schedule a testing center appointment. It's $170 at this moment in time. It could fluctuate, it could go up, could go down, but you can't take it at home. You have to go to a proctor testing center. Most airports around you probably have them, whether it be a flight school or something like that. They'll have a testing center for you to go and take that test at. Now, the way that I was looking at it was an investment for my business, helping myself grow and helping my business grow as well by offering different services that other people didn't have yet or just couldn't legally offer because they didn't have their Part 107. Now, I know it definitely upped the quality of my business in general just because I know how to fly my drone in different airspaces now. So I can go on and unlock my drone for a Part 107 license if I'm in a Class D airspace or a Class C airspace or something like that where normally you wouldn't be able to fly. Me having the knowledge I do have, the FAA now allows me to fly in those certain areas. If you're filming an office building or some sort of a building within 2 miles of an airport, without your Part 107, you legally can't do it, first of all. And it's gonna be very difficult for you to do it because you're not gonna be able to unlock your drone. I know more recent drones actually lock down the drone entirely when you're flying in controlled airspace. By having a Part 107, you can ask the FAA for approval to fly in those areas, which is really, really important for you and your clients. So now you made your FAA tracking number, you registered for your exam through PSI online, you took the FlightReady drone course, you paid the $170 for the exam itself and you passed that. The next step for you is to get the results that you have from the exam. On the actual paper that they hand you when you pass the exam, there's going to be a number on that. Now, that exam number will let you register yourself through the FAA website once again, but this time in order to get your airman certificate. What's gonna happen once you register through that FAA website with your exam number is you'll either see a, I think it's a pass or a fail under there. Now obviously if you pass, your application will go under review by the FAA. It takes about 2 to 3 days for your application to go under review, and you'll get an email saying, congratulations, you passed, this and that, and you get a temporary airman certificate. I keep mine in my wallet until I get my real one, which is in the mail. They do take a while to get here, so I've heard it's about 6 to 8 weeks. So the next step before you actually go out and fly your drone once you receive your temporary airman certificate is you want to register your drone. The way that you register your drone is through FAA Drone Zone. Once again, I'm just going to link this in the description. You put in the serial number of your drone itself, and there's a whole bunch of questions that you have to answer about the drone that you have. I'm not going to go into depth about that right now. The most important thing that you do have to note is that you need to put your registration number on your drone and it needs to be visible on the outside. It can't be in the battery compartment, anything like that. I think there was a law change back in 2017 that, you know, was a revision to the registration law. Now you have to put it, I'm not gonna show you, but I have mine here right on the wing or on the arm. Just really easily accessible, and if somebody needs to see it, they don't have to go digging around my drone in order to find the actual registration number itself. But yeah, you go on FAA Drone Zone, register your drone through the FAA website, and I think it's another $5 in order to register it, but like I said, it's an investment for your business, and ultimately, it's gonna grow yourself and grow your production value, so it's really, really important to do that. It's important that you do maintain yourself, and every 2 years, you do need to take a recurrent exam, which you can do online at your house. That is a brand new rule that they actually just released a couple weeks ago, which is really awesome, and that is totally free for the recurrent exam, and it's a lot easier than the initial exam to get your license. But just make sure that you do that once every 2 years in order to maintain that drone license itself. So now you're all ready to go. You've set up your drone, you registered it with the FAA, and now you're a licensed drone pilot. You can go ahead and you can go make some money using your drone, but do fly carefully, do fly responsibly, and abide by all the rules that the FAA has provided to you. Also, be sure to keep up on your knowledge on the FlightReady app. I know I have it on my phone, I have it on my computer, and every once in a while, if I don't know the answer to something, I can always look it up in that app. There's a lot of vital information in there that it's really, really imperative for you to learn, and trust me, you're not gonna wanna miss out on it. So I appreciate you watching this video. If you have any questions, please leave them down below, and I'll do my best to answer them. I'm also gonna leave the description with all the websites that I use to get my drone license and a step-by-step guide on how you can do it too.